Welcome back to Joint Tutorials. Previous I discussed Class 7 Lesson 1 Food Components Part 2 over. Now Part 3. Let us do 4. Here we have to take all food components. Which food items contains carbohydrates, proteins, fats. We have to make a list. For example, potato contains carbohydrates. Okay, I have to keep tick mark in carbohydrates. Proteins, fats, absent in two. Okay. Oily food, sweets, it contains fats. I have to keep it. Like that, I have to make a list. Next one is the roughage. Next one is roughage. What is roughage? Roughage is the dietary fiber. So many fibers are there. Cotton fiber. Okay. Silk fiber. Cotton fiber helps in cotton gloves. Silk fiber, pattu sarees, okay, so many are there, fibers, flax fiber, okay, so many are there, but here fiber, roughage, dietary fiber, it is very very important to food conscient, okay, it is not digested in our body, but it is very very essential, conscient. This roughage helps in our digestion, okay, it helps to send out waste from our body. If its waste not goes outside, what will be happen? Waste forms some harmful tumors. It leads to carcinogenic. Means finally we will get some cancer. Like that problems will happen. That's why this roughage helps to send out waste from our body. It helps in constipation, free bowel movement. Okay. About roughage. What are the sources of roughage? Sources of roughage: vegetables, fruits. Palak, potato, okay, fruits, vegetables like bhindi, ridge gourd, beans, these are all food items contain roughage. It is a dietary fiber, it is an edible fiber. This cotton is not an edible fiber, silk is not an edible fiber, but this roughage is an edible fiber, okay, we can take as a food. This roughage, let us do five. One of the activity, we have to take some potatoes, that all we have to squeeze. Then we have to find out some thread-like structures. Okay, thread-like structures. What are that? That is nothing but that strands are the fiber. What is that? That strands are the fiber. That is the edible fiber. That is very, very important to in our body. It requires our body. It helps to send out waste from our body. That's why we have to take roughage. This is about to let us do fine activity. Next one, water. Next one, water. When we take so many food items, food in our mouth helps here. Salivary glands are there that helps to secrete saliva. Saliva is nothing but watery-like substance. It send inside here food is partially digested, send into the food tract here, send to the intestine, stomach, large intestine, small intestine, finally send out waste from the anus. This is our digestive system. Here water, here this first of all we have to discuss one pipe. We have to take cotton. This is not a pipe but a model. I have to try to keep inside. It's very horrible. It's not going inside. But when I keep dip in water, it's easily go inside. Like that, food items also, the help of water, it will go inside easily. It will enter inside our digestive tract. Here, whatever nutrients we are taking, carbohydrates, protein, vitamins, minerals, that all will absorb our body. Whatever waste is there, that will send outside from the body. Here, this water helps in our digestion. Okay, this water helps in digestion. It helps in absorb nutrients. It helps in absorb nutrients. Everyone requires water 3 liters per day. Everyone requires 3 liters water per day. That's why you have to take sufficient water. 1 liter it will goes in our diet, like watery food or solid food items like that, it will go inside. But we have to take 8 glasses of water, that means 2 liters. Totally, we have to take 3 liters of water. This is about the water and refuse. Refuse and water very, very important. These are not, it contains no nutrient value, but in our body requires refuse and water. Refuse also, ideal intake of women 35 to 45 grams per day. Men require 40 to 50 grams per day. This refuse helps cortisol hormone, regulates cortisol. It is the main stress hormone. We want to be happy, feel every day. There is no stress, means we have to take sufficient refuse. That is very good for our health. Here, water. Water also helps in weight loss. Okay? And in our body, fluids contain 70% of water. Okay? So, we have to take sufficient water. This is very, very important. Every day we have to take water. There is no nutritional value, but we have to take water. Very, very important for our body. All metabolic activities requires water. This is about refuse and water. Next one is the balanced diet. Every day we are taking food, that is our diet. Okay, everyone have their own diet based on their traditions, based on their food habits, depending upon climatic conditions. Everyone have diet, but balanced diet. Everyone have to take right amount of carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins, minerals. That is called balanced diet. A balanced plate contains carbohydrates, proteins,